way over. Wandering, I am lost as I travel along the white cliffs of Dover. Many rivers to cross, and it's only my will that keeps me alive. A woman left and she didn't say why. Well, I guess I have to try. The white cliffs of Dover, many rivers to cross, and it's only my will that keeps me alive. A woman left and she didn't say why. Well, I guess I have to try. Many rivers to cross, but just where to begin? I'm playing for time. There have been times I find myself some dreadful crime.
say a word of introduction.
I know God is working.
whatever you're in right now.
Smile, smile for me.
Smile.
Can you just smile for me?
And my people say,
oh, oh, oh.
Remember,
you look so much better when you smile.
Come on.
I almost gave up.
I almost gave up.
I can't explain.
But the Holy Ghost power, y'all.
Fell from heaven.
Came
like
down from heaven. Hardships, difficulties.
Right now.
Tears, storms. This is what I do.
I smile.
Woo.
Even though I hurt, see, I smile.
Boy, that feels good.
I know God is working, so I smile.
All things are working.
Even though I'm in it for a while.
Right now.
Sure would hate to see you give up now.
Because you're a winner.
You look so much better when you smile.
You look better.
So smile.
Oh, oh, oh. Dallas.
You look so much better when you
New Orleans.
You look so much better when you
come on. Cleveland.
You look so much better when you
Detroit.
You look so much better when
yeah. Philly.
You look so much better.
We meet in the name of Jesus Christ, who died and was raised to the glory of God the Father. Grace and mercy be with you all. We have come here today to this house of prayer to remember before God our brother Patrick, to give thanks for his life and all that he meant to those who knew him and loved him. We come to commend him to God, our merciful Redeemer and Judge, to commit his body to be buried and to offer one another comfort at this time of grief. And although we have to do these things at a time when restrictions limit what we can do and how we can do it, we nonetheless today commend Patrick to God's safekeeping, trusting that his love is in no way diminished by our current circumstances. And nor is the hope that Patrick may share in the resurrection of Jesus. And so as we gather to do all these things, let us pray. Merciful Father, hear our prayers and comfort us. Renew our trust in your Son, whom you raised from the dead. Strengthen our faith that Patrick and all who have died in the love of Christ will share in his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you now and forever. Amen. One of the sadnesses of the current situation is that we cannot sing hymns together. And I'm very sorry about that. But we can nonetheless hear recordings of hymns sung. So let us now hear the hymn, I Have Found a Friend in Jesus.
He's the face.
Could I now invite Anne-Marie to come and give her tribute to Patrick?
Good morning, everyone. I'm taking my mask off because I can't breathe with it on, so whilst I give my tribute to Patrick and the loved ones that he leaves behind. I've known Patrick for many years. I used to see Patrick walking Stony Stanton Road in his shorts, and I used to also admire his legs. He used to have really nice, shiny legs. And then when he met my friend Faye and they got married, it was a day when it was as if to say he was going to come bulge with excitement. He was so happy. It was such a memorable day. Yet hearing the sad news that Patrick passed and trying to come to terms with it, Patrick was a lovely person. He was kind, he was gentle, he was so unassuming, and yet the poetry that he wrote spoke for him. He was amazingly talented. And my memories of Patrick will live on forever, especially on the day of his marriage to Faye. I remember him saying now he could get fried dumpling and curry chicken and stew chicken at all times. Without having to request it, it was now his right. I remember one time when we went somewhere and Patrick, the song was singing, Precious Memories, How They Linger, How They Ever Flood My Soul. In the stillness of the midnight, secret scenes unfold. I just want to encourage the family to hold on to them precious memories, because we all have them. And when you think of Patrick and truly the goodness of him, he was such an amazing, quiet, simple man who will truly be missed. I send my love and my sympathies to each and every one of you. And in my closing, I remember early last year, Patrick wrote a poem personally to Faye, and I'd like to read that for your hearing this day. It was written on the 21st of October, 2020. And it says, Faye, I don't care what the devil says. Even out of your mouth every day. Faye, I love you more than I can say every day. Don't you leave me. Don't you not be here, Faye, because that would be the trying and the ending of my day. Amen.
Thank you for those warm words. I know it's not easy to speak on an occasion like this, but thank you for sharing those words with us. Could I now invite Roy to come and give his tribute to Patrick?
A poem for Patrick, my brother, the Ashanti vigilante. Born Patrick Michael Barrett on the day of the festival of Patrick. Quiet and peaceful, deep in thought, sometimes doubtful, never boastful, always thoughtful. You stood tall with a memory that surpassed us all. You could recall multitudes from afar. What a superstar you really are. We were aware of your stare. Wide-eyed, you would see and feel the battle within, sometimes on a whim. So hard to tame, leaving you lame. There is no shame and no one to blame. precise, artistic and specific, holding up your chin with that cheeky grin. Your love was never wrapped in a glove. It was just there for all to share. You were a learner, a reader, fiercely independent, not one to be dependent. I am a surviving survivor, you would say. Writing and singing songs, championing the rights of those who have been wronged. Fair, kind, loving, and humorous, a shining light, loved by many. Patrick Ashanti, precious as a sacred Asawada stool, you were so cool. Adopting your tribe, 60% Ashanti, that's your vibe. Rest in peace, Patrick. Your Ashanti ancestry has claimed you, their vigilante. Thank you.
Thank you, Roy, for sharing those poetic words. And clearly the gift of poetry is one you share with your brother. Thank you for sharing those with us. So could I now invite Dev to come and give the eulogy for Patrick?
Thank you. Hi, good afternoon, everyone. Patrick was born on the 17th of March, 1959. And from that moment he was born, there was excitement, stories, and happiness which followed him throughout his life. Patrick was the firstborn in the UK for the immediate family. I remember Mom telling the story that the midwife was Irish and she was so excited and happy to deliver a boy born on St. Patrick's Day. The midwife also said, "You've done something that all Irish family would like, so please could you call him Patrick Michael?" And Mom agreed, so that made choosing his name very, very easy. And the other siblings are Fritz, Dev, Roy, Patrick, Lolly and Elaine, David and Eddie. Patrick went to Little Heath Primary School, then Broadheath and Sydney Stringer. Throughout Patrick's childhood, he suffered from asthma and eczema, so he was not able to participate in all activities as a child. I remember when Patrick was 11 years old, he got fanatic about golf. He had a real good interest in golf, a bit before Tiger Woods did, actually. To the level where it was unreal, he just couldn't put it down. And then I noticed, you know, for the rest of his life, everything he did, he was like 100% plus. He was also a keen martial artist. He started training in Kung Fu, then he went on to karate and kickboxing. He was very strong and flexible. That was his main point. His flexibility was really unreal. He went on to win a gold medal in a team in one of the regional championships, so he was way above the average martial artist at the time. Patrick's first job was in the electrical industry. He worked for a company called Adkins & Barker, and they were in Earlston, and his job was to repair domestic appliances, which he really, really enjoyed. His next job was at the Ford car factory in Leamington Spa, where he was there for a while, and he realized that's not where his future laid. So Patrick took some time out. He spent about 10 years studying and attending BTEC courses, including music, sound engineering, photography, and awareness courses. And also during that time, he met and married Faye, 30th of September, 2006. Patrick also developed a love for music, and he loved all aspects of music, singing, writing, recording, and playing, and sometimes playing very loud. He had neighbors who always loved his music and encouraged him to play louder, but there was also the neighbors who was totally against it, and that caused a little bit of upset in the neighborhood at the time. Patrick was a very intelligent person. So proud to have him as a brother. He was always happy, pleasant, easy to get on with. He was someone I would class as always fair and reasonable. So I would very often ask him advice, although he's my younger brother, advice on issues that I may have had to deal with. And you can guarantee Patrick always come up with an answer. Patrick had a way of commanding and getting respect from people from all walks of life. It was quite strange listening to him talking to the doctors while he was in hospital and actually explaining to them what they should be doing. So, but that was Patrick. There was something about him that people liked, and they had a lot of respect for him. He also assisted in the church. He was an usher to Pastor Higgins. He helped to prepare services and read scriptures. And Mrs. Higgins told me last week how good he was. He was excellent, he's one of the best, and he was always willing to help. Patrick has left behind a legacy. His loving wife, Faye, three wonderful children, Christina, Isaac, and Louisa. Also three grandchildren, Mia, Adam, and Noah. He also left behind a range of music and poetry. And Patrick Ashanti, you will always be in our memory and our prayers. Peace and God bless.
Thank you, Dev. It's always hard to sum up someone's life in a few minutes, but thank you for giving us that wonderful portrait of your brother. Could I now invite Christina, Louisa, and Isaac to come and share their memories of Dad?
Hello everyone, thanks for coming. We'd like to share our memories of our dad by reading this tribute, written by our sister Louisa. You're a poet, a songwriter, musician, and a singer. You like to read and read and read some more. You changed your surname to reconnect with our ancestors. Like Nan still is, you're a storyteller. Whenever you spoke, people naturally listened. You'd go into detail describing people, places to set the scene only for it to be followed by a silly punchline, which would have you in its hysterics. You completed college course after college course. Even with your distrust of computers, you learned how to use them. On the good days, when you are able to communicate, I'd ask the three dreaded words, which cannot be answered in one sentence. You'd say you're still surviving. You were a fighter in martial arts when you were younger, than when you're fighting your daily battles within yourself. I don't know anyone who was as strong as you to deal with what you had to go through. Day in, day out, you've been described as fiercely independent and was notorious for this whenever you ended up. When I was younger, I indirectly learned about the talk when overhearing your accounts of racism that you were experiencing. It helped me be prepared for the prejudices that I still face today. You weren't always there, but when you were cracking jokes every 5 minutes. I owe my sweet tooth to you for visiting our house, bringing different packets of sweets. I don't know what it would have been like for you to watch us grow up from a distance at times. Saturdays were our day. Fast food, then either a trip to the cinemas or rented a VHS. Your love for film became my love of film studies.
You were a dreamer, creator, carver, collector, and a curator. You would share your dreams of a better life and a better world, crafted these dreams into beautiful songs and poems. You would collect the dreams of others in CDs, DVDs, and videotapes. And you would curate these vast collections so that every time we visited, you would share the dreams, educating and entertaining our young minds. We are forever grateful for your cultural education. You carved a beautiful chair and coffee table for us to keep. You built us a large Tudor-style wooden Wendy house when we were very young, which we absolutely loved. I just have memories of that. Our mum absolutely hated it because it took up the whole living room. But it was amazing. It was just like the best thing ever. You turned up with an upright piano for us to learn how to play. I liked your strong hugs, but was never keen on your cheek kisses because your moustache would tickle, which you knew. Those times when you had a Charlie Chaplin moustache was embarrassing, but you clearly didn't care. Walking. You'd walk everywhere. You'd have to slow your strides when walking with us. I always looked forward to your cooking. I can still remember how it all tastes. And your sound system got me interested in music technology at college. If I remember correctly, we both achieved the same grade. You believed in God. This got me soul searching. I always dreaded family reunions. There was always that elephant in the room feeling. But I'm grateful to Allah for the time that we got to spend together because I know that it's more than what most people had. Every positive phone conversation ended as if it was going to be our last. And now I understand why, because every conversation could have been our last. This time it was. I don't really know much about your dad, our granddad. However, I will make sure your grandchildren are told that their granddad wanted them to know that he loved them all. Love you, Dad.
It is hard to speak on these occasions, but I'm so glad you did and shared that tribute to your beautiful and creative father. Thank you for that. And amongst Patrick's many gifts was a gift for music and a gift for composition. And so as we hold our memories of Patrick in our hearts and our minds, let us hear, O Lord, which Patrick himself composed. could I now ask Davina to come and share with us a passage from Holy Scripture?
Good afternoon, everyone. This is a portion of the book of Revelation, chapter 21, verses 1 to 7. And I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I saw John, the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, "Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people. And God himself shall be with them and be their God. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, nor shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away." And he that sat upon the throne said, "Behold, I make all things new." And he said unto me, "Write, for these words are true and faithful." And he said unto me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of a fountain of water of life freely. He that overcometh shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son." Amen.
Thank you, Davina, for sharing with us that great vision from the Book of Revelation. That vision of the end of all things, when all is gathered up into the kingdom of heaven and injustice has been judged and put right, and sorrow and sighing and pain are no more, and death itself has been overcome. It's a great vision and something to encourage us as we journey through the struggles and the challenges of this life. Throughout his life, Patrick fought against many challenges and many struggles. But in his creative and thoughtful way, he always held on to a sense that there was something better. Through the creative things that he did, his writing, his poetry, his music, his carving, his cooking, his storytelling, all the things he did to encourage those who were dear to him, he encouraged people to believe there was something better than the challenges of this world, something better than the prejudices of this world and the illness of this world that made life so difficult for him at times. And yet Patrick also had a great faith in the Lord Jesus, knowing that whilst it was right and necessary for him to struggle against many challenges, ultimately it would be through the Lord Jesus that he would come to a fulfillment of his hopes. In the hymn that we heard at the beginning of this service, we heard the line, "Through Jesus I shall safely reach the goal." And it is our hope and our trust that through Jesus we will indeed reach the goal of the kingdom of heaven, where injustice has been put right and illness has been overcome, and that through the death and the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, even death itself will be no more. That is the great hope that is ours through all that Jesus has done for us. And it's the hope that today we claim for Patrick as we entrust him to God's safekeeping, praying that he will come to a place prepared for him in the kingdom of heaven, where he will no longer be touched by illness, will no longer be touched by prejudice, but will be free from those things and held safe in the loving arms of God, the God who made him, the God who redeemed him, and who, through the person of the Lord Jesus, came and shared our lives that we might share the life of heaven. That is our hope. That is the promise made to us. And it's the promise that today we claim for Patrick. Patrick, today we surround you with our love, our gratitude for all that you have been and all that you have done. And we surround you with our prayers that you may indeed share in the resurrection of Jesus and come to a place in the kingdom where you may be free from sorrow, sighing, and pain, and know the fullness of life for all eternity. Amen. Let us pray. Remember, O Lord, this your servant Patrick, who has gone before us with the sign of faith and now rests in the sleep of peace. According to your promises, grant to him and to all who rest in Christ refreshment, light, and peace. Through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Father in heaven, we thank you because you made us in your own image and gave us gifts in mind, body, and spirit. We thank you now for Patrick and for his many gifts, for his creativity, his music, his poetry, his encouragement of those who were dear to him, for his commitment to justice. And as we honour his memory, make us more aware that you are the one from whom comes every perfect gift, including the gift of eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Most merciful God, whose wisdom is beyond our understanding, surround all of Patrick's family with your love, that they may not be overwhelmed by their loss, but have confidence in your goodness and strength to meet the days to come. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Support us, O Lord, all the day long of this troublous life, until the shadows lengthen and the evening comes, the busy world is hushed, the fever of life is over, and our work is done. Then, Lord, in your mercy, grant us a safe lodging, a holy rest, and peace at the last. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. So let us join together in praying the words that Jesus himself taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Let us commend Patrick to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Would you please stand? God, our Creator and Redeemer, by your power Christ conquered death and entered into glory. Confident of his victory and claiming his promises, we entrust Patrick, Michael, Keto to your mercy in the name of Jesus our Lord, who died and is alive and reigns with you, now and forever. Amen. Hear us, O merciful Father, as we remember in love Patrick, whom we have placed in your hands. Acknowledge, we pray, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Enfold him in your loving arms of mercy, in the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and in the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. Blessed are those who have died in the Lord. Let them rest from their labours, for their good deeds go with them. Rest eternal grant unto Patrick, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon him. May he rest in peace. Amen. We have entrusted our brother Patrick to God's mercy, and in a moment we will escort his body to be laid to rest. Before we do that, I invite you to bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May God give you his comfort and his peace, his light and his joy in this world and the next. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Amen. Let us now escort the body of our brother Patrick to his final resting place.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Here at the place of burial, let us hear some words from the psalm. Some words from the psalm. The Lord is full of compassion and mercy, slow to anger and of great goodness. As a father is tender towards his children, so is the Lord tender to those that fear him. For he knows of what we are made. He remembers that we are but dust. Our days are like the grass. We flourish like a flower of the field. When the wind goes over it, it is gone, and its place will know it no more. But the merciful goodness of the Lord endures for ever and ever toward those that fear him, and his righteousness upon their children's children. We have entrusted our brother Patrick to God's mercy, and we now commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. In sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life, through our Lord Jesus Christ, who will transform our frail bodies, that they may be conformed to his glorious body, who died, was buried, and rose again for us. To him be glory for ever. Amen. Blessed are those who have died in the Lord. Let them rest from their labours, for their good deeds go with them. Rest eternal grant unto Patrick, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon him. May he rest in peace. Amen.
Na 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 na. thing you done with Lenton. They really do the thing.
That God is standing by. Hold on again when you have heartaches. Don't cry. Oh no, oh no. Remember that God is standing by. Sometimes when you first let down, just remember.
Thank you. Shields me from evil. I'm gonna shake my hands and feel. I'll be praying for you. Ooh, 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 ooh. I think that a song to say. When in the jungle and you touched a lion, and all that lion started to roar.
Thank you. Anybody else need to see?
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
Some people
think about these last days. Yeah. I must admit.
A poem for Patrick, my brother, the Ashanti vigilante. Born Patrick Michael Barrett on the day of the Festival of Patrick. Quiet and peaceful, deep in thought, sometimes doubtful, never boastful, always thoughtful. You stood tall with a memory that surpassed us all. You could recall multitudes from afar. What a superstar you really are. We were aware of your stare. Wide-eyed, you would see and feel the battle within, sometimes on a whim. So hard to tame, leaving you lame. There is no shame and no one to blame. Precise, artistic and specific, holding up your chin with that cheeky grin. Your love was never wrapped in a glove. It was just there for all to share. You were a learner, a reader, fiercely independent. Not one to be dependent. I am a surviving survivor, you would say. Writing and singing songs, championing the rights of those who have been wronged. Fair, kind, loving, and humorous, a shining light, loved by many. Patrick Ashanti, precious as a sacred Asawada stool, you were so cool. Adopting your tribe, 60% Ashanti, that's your vibe. Rest in peace, Patrick. Your Ashanti ancestry has claimed you, their vigilante.